What's the most outlandish myth that you've heard about COVID-19?
Hi everyone, I'm Dr. Seema Yasmin. I'm a doctor and a medical journalist with the Stanford Center for Health Education. There's a ton of false information spreading about the pandemic. Today, we're gonna debunk some of these myths. Keep in mind, there are trusted sources of fact-checked, accurate information about COVID, including the CDC website. So let's get started with 7 of the most common myths about COVID. Myth number 1, the origin of the COVID-19 pandemic is known. This is false. Many governments around the world, including the US government, are studying how this pandemic might have begun. It's inaccurate and it's xenophobic to assume that one country or one population is responsible for the pandemic. We need a ton more research to really understand where the virus originated and how it spread to humans. There's a possible theory that SARS-CoV-2 may have originated in bats, and after mutating, which means changing its genetic code, it began to infect humans. Myth number 2, COVID-19 is an invented pandemic resulting from misuse of 5G radiation. This is false. 5G means fifth generation mobile networks, which provide faster connectivity. Viruses cannot travel on radio waves and mobile networks, and COVID-19 is spreading in many countries that do not have 5G mobile networks. Part of this myth is this idea that radio waves and electromagnetic radiation from phone towers can make people sick. This is also not true. Myth number 3, the COVID vaccine making process was rushed and COVID vaccines are unsafe. It's untrue to say that the vaccines are unsafe. The process was done quicker than ever before, but COVID vaccines authorized for use in the US and Europe are safe. That's why I chose to get vaccinated. Not only did the CDC and FDA scrutinize vaccine data before authorizing these vaccines, but they continue to monitor safety following the massive rollout of the vaccines. Until now, we've seen 2 kinds of adverse reactions to vaccines, both of them incredibly rare. The first is a severe allergic reaction, which occurs in about 2 to 5 people for every million who get vaccinated. This kind of reaction typically happens in about 30 minutes after getting vaccinated, and it can be effectively treated right away. The second type of adverse reactions are blood clots. These are also very rare and happen to about 1 out of every 400,000 people who get the Johnson & Johnson vaccine, and about 1 in every 150,000 people who gets the AstraZeneca vaccine. Myth number 4, only the elderly or people with underlying health conditions can get seriously ill with COVID and need to go to hospital for it. While it is true that the elderly and those with underlying conditions are most likely to become very ill and to die from COVID, we've seen people of all ages die from this disease. Here in the US, nearly 3,000 18 to 29 year olds have died from COVID. Many more in this age group have been hospitalized with serious complications. Younger people can, of course, also pick up the virus that causes COVID and spread it to more vulnerable people. And bear in mind that COVID-19 can lead to respiratory failure, lasting lung and heart muscle damage, nervous system problems, kidney failure, and death in people across ages. Myth number 5, it's better and safer to get COVID than to get the COVID vaccine. This is definitely false. Getting the vaccine is a far safer option than getting the infection. COVID vaccines protect you from this disease and protect you from the many long-term side effects that COVID can cause. Out of the tens of millions of people who've been vaccinated in the US, there have been a few thousand reports of death. After CDC experts reviewed data from all possible vaccine-related deaths, it was determined that there is no link between COVID vaccines and these deaths. Unfortunately, the same cannot be said for COVID itself. As of September 2021, more than 645,000 people have died from COVID in the US. This means that even if we count every single incidental death reported to the CDC with regard to vaccines, you're still 1,000 times more likely to die from COVID. So myth number 6, COVID vaccines cause infertility or miscarriage. This is false. There's no evidence to support this claim, and experts in reproductive health, including people that work at the American Society for Reproductive Medicine, have evaluated the evidence and said there's no loss of fertility among the millions who've received COVID vaccines. Scientists recommend that pregnant people get vaccinated. A small number of people have reported temporary changes in their periods after getting a COVID vaccine, but this is not linked to a change in fertility. Finally, there's this myth: vaccines can cure COVID. COVID vaccines are designed to prevent severe COVID. They don't cure you of the disease. The goal of the vaccines is to build up your immune system so that your body is prepared to fight infection if and when you are exposed to the virus that causes COVID. That's all for now, but let me sneak in one final myth, because you might be hearing this one that says the pandemic is over, and that is definitely not true. We need to make sure that billions of people get access to COVID vaccines, because that's what's going to get us out of this pandemic. That's all from me for now. Click on the links below for more information. Check out our YouTube channel for more videos, and stay safe.